Welcome back, guys, to another episode of the Metal Gear Solid Campaign Walkthrough Part 2. If you guys have been enjoying the walkthrough so far, please make sure to slam that like button below. And subscribe, and there's Psycho Mantis once again. And the...
Come on.
And the Fury Pegasus. That was the guy that saved us in the last part. Don't really know who he is. I think it might be Ocelot if you guys have played the past Metal Gear Solid games, or even watched past Metal Gear Solid games. The last part was kind of graphic and a little bit intense.
The name's Ocelot. Big boss. You know who I am. A certain man gave me a job to do. Two, actually. First was to get you out of that hospital. The second was to rescue the man himself.
But see, in Metal Gear Solid 3 Snake Eater, they were enemies, so this is kind of confusing.
You remember? Your partner, 9 years ago, Kazuhita Miller.
Also, Master Miller.
9 years back, your private army came under attack by Cypher. You were considered dead. Until today, that is, when Cypher found you. And it's not just them. The whole world wants you dead. You'll have to join up with Miller. Build that private army of yours one more time. It's your only chance.
So I was right about that being Ocelot. But I'm also kind of confused because...
First, we need to save Miller. He's in Afghanistan.
Afghanistan.
Because, like I said, they were enemies.
What, can't keep up with world affairs in a coma? 4 years ago, the Soviets invaded Afghanistan. Muslims are fighting back with Western support. Miller was training Mujahideen rebels when he was captured by the Soviets. The Red's 40th Army. Troop strength somewhere around 100,000. The squad holding Miller set off near the Pakistan border yesterday. Now in 3 days, they'll reach the Soviet garrison. He'll be interrogated for a few more days. That's off to a lager. Or left to rot in a ditch on Afghan soil.
Apologize if you hear your background noise, by the way.
I give him 2 weeks. The job didn't mean anything to Miller. He only took it on to keep you safe. Well, there's our ride. It's a whaling ship. Had a pretty good deal on her once the IWC started raising a stink. Now, 7 days to Port Cassim. Another 3 overland, so we won't have much time once we're there. Don't take too long getting used to your new self. Hang on.
So this is very unique. Ocelot helping us out, giving us some information on Master Miller. I'm going to kind of refer to these guys as they were known in like Metal Gear Solid 1 or whatever game they were first introduced in. So if you guys are kind of confused by how I'm referencing these characters, I apologize, but that's how I kind of remember them. So we're just going to roll that. Yeah, last part was graphic, it was intense, but it was so awesome at the same time. So far I'm impressed with Metal Gear Solid 5, The Phantom Pain. Graphic wise, Chapter 1, Revenge. Let's get right into this game. I mean, we already got into the game, but.
Thank you.
There's the arm. I'm just letting you guys listen to the game soundtrack. Metal Gear Solid is known for its awesome soundtracks, so. If you guys didn't know, Metal Gear Solid 5, Ground Zeroes and the Phantom Pain are both kind of open world, so. At least that's, yeah, I'm pretty sure it's open world. Would you look at that? I got a reward for listening to the whole entire cutscene. That's pretty cool. Episode 1, Phantom Limb. So this is kind of interesting. It's going to be broken down into episodes. So this is quite interesting. March 21st, 1984, Northern Kabul, Afghanistan. 1406. I think this was shown off at E3 or somewhere.
The area ahead is under total Soviet control. Miller's been captive for 10 days. Not much time left.
Weather will clear shortly.
Storm's passing.
No, depending on how long, like, the game episodes are, I'll cut it off as that. Or we'll do about, like, a half hour part. For each, yeah. I don't know. Still need to figure out the kinks, but you guys also said you'd watch it regardless when I put the poll on Twitter.
9 years on ice.
So.
Solo infiltration of the Soviet-made ground forces. Be the perfect one. Kazuhira Miller is being held in Darwin Day Mart. Check its location now. Take out your item. You see Wandi on the map? That's where they're keeping Miller. Only problem is, we don't know his exact location. Finding it is your first priority.
Marker placed.
Got your binoculars? Or should I say, in scope? See the village? Straight ahead? To the right. Look up. To the right. All right, that's the village. If you see something through the binoculars and you need more information, just give me a call. I'll tell you anything I can about it. That's VLO Village, the VLO Palais. The villagers fled the war and evacuated a while back. Since then, it's become a base for the Soviet's 40th Army. A few days ago, Miller was taken through there, en route towards Dewandehan. You may be able to pick up the trail then. It's worth a shot. Put a marker on it so you don't lose track of where it is. Good. Now you won't have to worry about getting lost along the way.
Can't have much left in him. I give him 3 days, tops. We fail. He dies. We lose our chance of revenge. But we need more intel. You just go charging into Dewandehan, you'll be putting both your lives at risk. See what you can find out first. The Soviets have other outposts, not just the one you saw. Afghanistan is a big place. I expect you'll become quite familiar with those binoculars as you plan your next move. How and where you make it, well, that's up to you. From here on out, you're on your own. You're a legend in the eyes of those who live on the battlefield. That's why you have to handle this mission yourself. Put those 9 years behind you, and return as Big Boss. That's how Koss would want it. I'll be sending additional intel by radio. Stay sharp. Not one of Miller's bodyguards survived. And they were good. All we found on the scene were their corpses and these. You'll be missing them. And you're his only hope of getting them back.
Oh, whoa. That shrapnel is stuck in his head. Oh my god.
Now go! Let the legend come back to life.
So this is pretty interesting. Horseback riding in a Metal Gear Solid game. So we're gonna go to the village first. And see what we can find there. So we found a rough diamond, so that's pretty cool and interesting. So there's one guard over there. Seems like he's the only guard.
Sight, sound, keep all your enemy senses in mind. When you're near an enemy, stay low and move slowly.
One more sentry. So we have the enemy right now. I guess that we can put him in that locker, can we not?
It looks like that horn stuck in your head has impacted the latent. Don't leave bodies out in the open. Find some place to drop them out of sight. A portable toilet. If you're gonna hide inside, watch the enemy doesn't decide to use it. Same goes for hiding downed enemies in it.
So I think that this might have been a building right here. It's barricaded. More rough diamonds. I'm just looking around. Being tactical like in any other Metal Gear Solid game.
Spit it out. Speak.
Understanding a language and being able to interpret from that language for somebody else are two different things. Juggling languages at a rapid-fire pace is more difficult than you might think. So, in other words, while I do speak Russian, don't expect me to do your interpreting.
Wow. It's kind of rude. Rude of Ocelot to say something like that. Just looking around for rations and whatnot. I was just about to say that. Making a lot of noise. Okay, then. There we go.
Extraction arrived at
the... You're almost at the enemy outpost, Violo Village. The village is crawling with enemy soldiers. Don't just go waltzing in. Start with some recon. Is there anywhere that overlooks the village?
Is there anywhere that overlooks the village? I think we might have found the spot. So look at that.
Look at where the enemies are stationed. Look at their gear. Take it all in. There should be a command post somewhere. See any buildings with tighter security? If there are clues to Miller's whereabouts, I'll bet you can find them in there.
This seems to look...
Some kind in there.
Guess where there's yep. One enemy there. Don't think it'd be smart to just bring the horse over there, so what we're gonna do is we're gonna just kind of walk our way. That is actually open, so we're gonna go in there. Another rough diamond. There's a lot of these rough diamonds. Watch them become like totally rare as the game goes on. So we're getting close to the command post. We're playing it safe, we're playing it stealthy. In the words of Chris Smooth, playing stealthy is healthy. There we go. Here in a vehicle. I can't tell where it's coming from, though. Sounds like it's fading a bit, so we're gonna keep on moving. So we're gonna try to find a... Nope. I think we might have found our way. Fuel resources. Collecting as many resources as we can.
Sun's down already. It goes without saying that darkness is good for you.
There we go. We got that intel. We gained that intel, I should say. Is that it?
Now we know where Miller is. I'm marking it on your iDroid.
Oh.
The map has been updated.
How do we unmark? Oh, there we go.
Marker removed. Marker removed.
So now I know exactly where he is.
Marker placed.
So the sun is setting. That'll help more with our stealth. Oh. To be a tad bit more careful with our with how we handle the stealth from here on out. Well, at least with our weapon, because anything can happen at this point. And that's kind of the thing, like, when you, and the reason why I'm saying, like, be more resourceful is that if you see on the lower right-hand corner of your screen, you'll notice the pistol. and how it says suppressor, and there's a little bar. Suppressors actually were out in this Metal Gear Solid game. They introduced that in Metal Gear Solid 3 Snake Eater. So, yeah, be more careful. Can we climb over this? I know it's barbed wire. Of course we can. We can just climb over anything because we're big boss. Alrighty. Gonna see if there's anybody out there. Hit a checkpoint. Uh oh, hold up. So there's quite a few enemies, so we're gonna dismount and see what we can do. We're able to sneak past them, and that's awesome. And that's what I'm hoping for. And just like that. I'm gonna do a little bit more of some recon, and then we'll make sure that it's good to go for us to bring in the Diamond Dog horse. Question is, okay, so we hit a checkpoint, that's good. Question is, which way do we go? Let's pull out this hydra. Okay, so we just keep on going that way.
Medicinal plant. Bring it back to base. It's sure to be useful sometime.
Hold up, what is that? Oh, it's the sheep. You can dolphin dive, that's pretty nice. It is kind of slow paced, I will say that, but you know, tis what it is. We got a spotlight there, a spotlight there, and some sort of generator there. Another somewhere right there.
Marker removed.
So we have to figure out a way to, let's call Ocelot for help.
Not a civilian in sight. The Soviets have taken complete control of the place.
Alright, so we're about to see how skillful I am.
You've reached one day. They've got Miller locked up in that town. Check your iDroid for his location. I hope to hell he's alright. He's not your average client.
Average client, alright. Okay, hold on. So, all right. So yeah, somewhere in that area is Miller. We just have to be very careful because there are sentries, some spotlights. I may end up shooting.
Extraction arrived at Mother Base.
Okay. I may end up shooting one of the spotlights just to make it easier. That may need to be done, so we'll switch to this just in case. So there's another center right there. We are close to getting to Miller. I don't like that. I don't like that. Can they even see me? Okay, so there's a lot of enemies now. If this doesn't move anytime soon, I'll cut ahead. That is nerve-wracking. Can I shoot lights? Cool. Okay, so this is the building. This is actually kind of intense. I haven't played a stealth game in a long time. Okay, so this is the building. Oh, jeez. Oh, this is great. Oh, that's Kaz right there. Oh boy.
God. Not much use for me, huh? Kaz, it's me. I'm here to get you out. They do something to your eyes? No, it's just bright as all. Took you so long. We'll talk about here.
And just like that, we are going to end it right here. I hope you guys did enjoy. If you guys did, please make sure to slam that like button below. Subscribe to make sure this video gets in your sub box. Don't forget to follow me on Twitter for the latest updates. Don't forget to turn on notifications. That's probably the most efficient way to know when videos like these hit your sub boxes. And yeah, that's pretty much it, guys. I will see you guys in the next part. Peace.